have as a special treat a guest speaker, Margaret Mead. She is a pioneer in the field work of anthropology. She is a curator emeritus of the American Museum of Natural History. She has many publications, among one of her most famous, The Coming of Age in Samoa. Margaret Mead is a Renaissance woman, a pioneering anthropologist, a writer, a humanist, a woman of brilliance, and we are indeed honored to have this great woman with us today.
When Margaret Mead passed away in 1978, she was renowned as the most famous anthropologist in the world. Through her life's explorations, encounters, and exchanges, the public learned through all advancements in media about her research, anthropology, and the social, cultural aspects of humankind. In her early 20s, Mead initiated her first anthropological fieldwork to study the cultures of the Pacific Islands. Anthropology was her life's work, in which many accolades would later follow. She was posthumously awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom in 1979 for a lifetime of research, teaching, refining anthropology techniques, and studies. By Mead's use of media to communicate anthropology to the public, she became an icon in her field, an in-demand anthropologist and satisfying the demands of the public to understand more of the mysteries of humankind. This is the story of Margaret Mead, anthropology, and the emergence into the public sphere, being in the right place at the right time. American Anthropological Association defines anthropology as the study of humankind, past and present. Anthropology's main concerns are the applications of knowledge to solution of problems. This had soon become Mead's quest. Margaret Mead was born in 1901 in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. She was born into a family of highly educated people. Her father was a university economics professor, and her mother was a sociologist. Another major influence in her life was her grandmother, Martha Mead, a child psychologist. She taught Margaret when she was young to observe younger children's behaviors and the motives behind their actions. For most of her youth, Margaret was homeschooled, with emphasis on social issues. She proceeded to pursue a college education in psychology. In her final year at Barnard College in New York, Margaret studied anthropology taught by Franz Boas, soon to become her mentor. She considered this to be the most powerful event in her life, hence guiding her into the field of anthropology. After graduating in 1923, she transferred to Columbia University's Anthropology Department and eventually working with her mentor, Franz Boas and Ruth Benedict, who later collaborates with Mead's continued field studies. What was also coinciding at the same time was the public's thirst to know more about other primitive societies, exotic places, and the unknowns of humankind. The public's interest was spurred on with publications such as the National Geographic magazine, first published in 1888, bringing the outside world to the public through photos and stories in print. For many living in the Western world, these places were not easily accessible for the majority. The public wanted to know more, a deeper understanding of cultures, other areas of the world. With this aspiration, Margaret Mead and the art of anthropology began to grow, not only for scholarly study, but to satisfy the public's demands to understand more of the dynamics of humankind.
Initially, I think the most important thing I did was to introduce anthropology to the general literate public. That was why I was brought here to the American Museum of Natural History.
At the start of her career as an anthropologist, Margaret Mead's first fieldwork took her to the Pacific Islands. In 1925, she set out alone on a year's venture to Samoa, living in Tu'u Manoa, an atoll of American Samoa, to study the social, cultural dynamics and customs of the island's primitive people. Mead focused her research in adolescent girls, their roles, stresses, and transitions to adulthood, to be compared to American and European adolescent girls. Upon her return to the United States and based on her research, she authored her first book in 1928, Coming of Age in Samoa. This book would soon become a bestseller, captivating her audiences to the studies of primitive cultures. The book became the most widely read book in the field of anthropology at that time, which was also promoted and distributed to the public worldwide and in different languages. In my interview with David Herdwich, Historic Preservation Officer in American Samoa, Masters in Anthropology, it was his opinion that the general impact of Mead's research, books on Samoa and Pacific Islands, was not immediate, yet generated more public interest putting Samoa and other areas on the map, and promoting more Western civilization contact, influence, and eventually cultural changes. In the later part of 1928, Mead proceeded to travel and research a new primitive society, traveling to New Guinea. She focused on the early period of child development in a primitive society. This study generated her next book, Growing Up in New Guinea, distributed in 1930. With the enormous popularity of these two books, Mead discovered anthropology's public education potential and the thirst for more. She was able to bridge the gap of anthropological study and fieldwork to the general public's level of understanding. These books catapulted Margaret Mead as a pioneering researcher and seen as the most famous anthropologist in the world. In the 1930s, Mead's comparative fieldwork continued in New Guinea, and in 1935, her new book, Sex and Temperament in Three Primitive Societies, was released and widely read. In 1936, Margaret Mead and her husband, British anthropologist Gregory Bateson, returned to New Guinea and Bali for further research. The pair utilized advancements in filming technology as a part of their research data collection, becoming the new visual anthropology, a visual record that allows scholars to examine, verify their findings, and be available for the public through discussions and lectures. Mead's use of new advancing media mediums and anthropological research were emerging. New ways of communication would follow, and Mead, her research in anthropology, would escalate. Margaret Mead's career was extraordinary, consisting of more than 35 books, hundreds of films, and tapes. Her research was cited within and outside the world of anthropology. She became an in-demand lecturer, social science communities, religious groups, and international agencies, along with journalists, magazine publishers, radio and television medias, sought her advice and knowledge. Margaret Mead actively participated and enjoyed in the dissemination of anthropological ideas and utilized all technical advancements in media. With the development of commercial radio in the 1920s and 30s, her works were disseminated. Her anthropology studies were heard on the airwaves. Television was emerging across America and into people's homes in the 1950s. Mead soon appeared on many talk shows, communicating her research and ongoing views of anthropology and society. She was teaching and exciting the public even more. Her audiences continued to grow, and her knowledge, anthropology skills were in demand. Time magazine in 1969 referred to her as Mother of the World. Margaret Mead became a household name, and the dynamics of anthropology impacted many to start careers in anthropology and other social sciences. Mead was not afraid to confront issues of the day and the impacts or solutions. She worked continuously throughout her life, even addressing Congress and current society issues. She evolved in her life, her research, and continued to collaborate with the advancement in media technology. Mead's decades of work became more refined through praise and criticism, creating new processes within anthropological studies and opening a door for new interests, such as global studies, new social sciences.
There was some controversy about whether or not she always found what she was looking for when she went out in the field, but I've never seen any evidence that how she reported things wasn't accurate.
Throughout the 20th century, Mead's words were printed, listened to, and her face became widely known. Her expertise was sought, and the demands of the public in education were being satisfied. A small-statured woman whose personal drive, research, and work enabled her to become an in-demand media star, making her accomplishments in life so much bigger. Margaret Mead's anthropological fieldwork consisted of exploration, encounter, and exchange, and in the right place at the right time can certainly be applied to Mead in anthropology. Margaret Mead also made explorations into the advancements in media. She encountered each change, embraced and utilized those advancements, and in exchange, Mead, her works, her stature, and anthropology awareness would grow. She delighted in communicating and impacting people's lives through her research in any media. Mead once stated her conviction to never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. She certainly did. Mead may not have envisioned the magnitude of our latest advancements in media technology, the fields of computer sciences. At the touch of a computer keyboard, within an internet cloud, and accessible in seconds, Mead and anthropology would never be forgotten. Margaret Mead, anthropology, and her lifetime of research and communications will always remain in the public sphere, available and teaching forever.